Hey up, lad. Go wait to Leeds. Hey up, lad. Go wait to Leeds.
Okay, welcome to the vlog.
Okay, so this is the vlog. Okay, guys, so this is my vlog for Warrington versus Lara 2. I'm in Brum at the moment. It's about 2 p.m. I will leave for Leeds at about 3. But yeah, looking forward to it. Super excited to see Josh come back. For those of you who don't know, Josh lost against Lara, who was kind of like a last minute replacement. And it was a massive shock because Warrington was literally on a roll. He was undefeated. And then this kind of unknown guy comes in and beats him. But now it's a rematch. It's in Leeds, his hometown. The whole city comes out to see Josh. Ignore my mum. She's talking in the background. But yeah, so big fan of Josh. Big fan of his dad, Mr. Johnny Kebab. Shout out Johnny Kebab. Can't wait to see him in the corner. Yeah, so Josh, it's a must win for him to get his career back on track. If he wants to get back to being a champion and try and unify the division, which was his original plan, he has to win today. The last fight was in Eddie Hearn's garden. It was in February during like strict COVID times. Now it's in what's the arena called? Oh great, let me check. It's called Headingland or something like that. Headingley Cricket Ground it is. 20,000 people sold out. Kind of got tickets kind of close to the front, so I should be able to get some good shots from there. But yeah, let's go, Josh, man, let's go. Okay, just leaving now to go to Leeds, 3 p.m. Time to go. Little update, nothing more to say. We'll be back in about 2 hours. Let's go, Josh, let's go.
Here we go for Leeds United. We're gonna give the boys a hand. Stand up and sing for Leeds United. They are the greatest in the land. Here we were. You're gonna say we love you, Leeds. Leeds, Leeds.
Leeds, Leeds, Leeds. 91. Leszek Jankowiak, 97 to 93. All three for your winner by unanimous decision. He's still undefeated and still the WBA Continental Welterweight Champion, Conor the Destroyer.
Josh, let's go.
Is removed, and that is a giant cut. And surely Mauricio Lara here is on borrow time, and Steve Gray now is talking to the corner. And referee Steve Gray has decided to wave it off.
So it's been a few months, obviously, since that fight happened, but I still remember everything clearly. I stopped filming after the stoppage in the second round because, obviously, as you know, I was really excited to see Josh fight, and it stopped because of a headbutt after the second round. So I didn't really get an end to that fight, and everyone in the arena was pissed off. Like, walking out from the arena, everyone was like, oh, I'm not coming again to see Josh fight. Listen, obviously, everyone paid good money to go there, and obviously, we didn't get the fight that we wanted. I feel, though, Conor Benn was on the card and I got to see him fight live, and he's basically a main eventer in his own right. And after that fight, he main evented a card and KO'd Chris Algieri with a beautiful KO. And he was a standout fighter on that card. He looked so quick. His head movement was good. His technique looked amazing. He was totally the standout fighter. And it's no surprise to me he's come back and got that KO against Algieri. And I think he's going to become a world champion very, very soon. Yeah. And you can tell how hard he works just from his YouTube channel and stuff like that. So all respect to him. Now, in terms of Josh, I just felt like even in those two rounds, Lara looked a little bit too much for him. The power was just too much for him. I feel like Josh has got a great style. He comes forward. He's got cardio for days. Very aggressive fighter. And it's worked for him beautifully. But when his shots don't have any really effects on Lara, because he's just a tough Mexican boxer. And Lara's shots were affecting Josh quite a lot. So every time Lara got a shot, it would sort of, you know, move Josh a bit. But if when Josh hit Lara, nothing, it didn't really affect him. So I feel like maybe he got lucky there just to get that sort of draw from that headbutt. And he's moving on to go for the IBF featherweight title against Kiko Martinez in March. And this is not going to be an easy fight either. So I don't think it's fair that he gets to fight for a world title. But it's going to be a hard fight, and if he wins, then he deserves it anyway. My opinion, I'm biased because I'm a Josh fan. I'm a Josh fan. even though I was upset after that fight, but yeah, I feel like Josh is the younger fighter. He's just got to be in and out fast. Don't get caught up in the sort of exchanges too much. Just be a smart fighter, in and out, fast combos, because as you saw against Kid Galahad. So Kiko Martinez fought Kid Galahad last fight and KO'd Kid Galahad. But Kid Galahad was winning all the rounds up until the shot that knocked him down the next round, then he got finished. And, you know, Josh and Kid had a very close fight. So Josh's got to be careful just to not get touched by a hard shot. And I feel like he can do it and get the IBF featherweight title. Great night. You know, I'd recommend anyone to go see a boxing match. And the next Josh's one's going to be in Leeds again. Might go, I'm not too sure, but definitely be watching, definitely be supporting Josh. Shout out Johnny Kebab as well. Johnny Kebab is Josh's dad, and he's hilarious. He's like, and his interviews are just gold. So, and he was humble enough, you know, his son's fighting on the card, and he was humble enough to take a picture with the fans, take a picture with me and stuff like that. So shout out Johnny Kebab, as always. Shout out Josh. I should have dropped this vlog earlier, but I hope you enjoyed it. And if you did enjoy it and you want to see more, comment, like, subscribe. But yeah, hope I can bring you another vlog. Maybe UFC London's coming up soon. Me and Sonny might go to that one. So yeah, stay tuned. Keep it locked.